Hello everyone, this is Gyati Gupta and you are watching Vocab Builders. This video will be based on the basic vocabulary of different types of breads. So it's a request to watch the video till the end. Firstly, understand how is the bread made. The basic method to prepare the bread is by mixing flour and other ingredients like milk or egg or sugar or spice or fruits etc. with water, followed by the process of fermentation and then cutting it the dough into required shape of bread. So that is the traditional one, but there are other several advanced methods as well. So we have hundreds of varieties of breads based on the ingredients used, like multigrain, fruit bread, milk bread, etc. And then based on the baking pattern, like some breads are highly baked and have huge volume, some are of moderate volume, and the rest are baked to be just flat breads. So this way we can have a scores of varieties in bread itself. But in this video, we will be discussing only the varieties we commonly see around us. So here I begin. On number 1, we have white bread. White bread typically refers to breads made from wheat flour from which the bran and germ layers have been removed. Natural oils are removed during the milling process, which allows white bread to be stored for longer periods of time, thus avoiding potential rancidity. Also note that white bread is sometimes referred to as sandwich bread and sandwich loaf. On number 2, we have brown bread. Brown bread is a designation often given to breads made with significant amounts of whole grain flour, usually wheat, and sometimes dark colored ingredients such as molasses or coffee. Then we have whole wheat bread or whole meal bread, which is a subset of brown bread only. It is a type of bread made using flour that is partly or entirely milled from wheat grains. Some varieties of this bread contains whole or cracked grains of wheat, though this is mostly decorative compared to the nutritional value of good quality of loaf itself. Then on number 4, we have rye bread. Rye bread is made with various proportions of flour from rye grain. It can be light or dark in color, depending on the type of flour used and the addition of coloring agents. When compared with white bread, it is denser, higher in fiber, darker in color, and stronger in flavor. And now, the next variety of bread is croissant. I know many of us might misread it as croissant or croissant, but it is croissant. A croissant is a buttery, flaky bread of Austrian origin. It is named for its historical crescent shape. Croissants are made of a layered yeast leaven dough. The dough is layered with butter, rolled and folded several times in succession, then rolled into a sheet in a technique called laminating. Then we have the next variety, a hot dog bun. A hot dog bun is a type of soft bun shaped specifically to contain a hot dog or another type of sausage. Then we have the next variety of bread, pretzel. A pretzel is a type of baked bread made from dough that is commonly shaped into a knot. In modern times, pretzels come in a wide range of shapes. Salt is the most common seasoning for pretzels. Other seasonings are cheeses, sugar, chocolate, cinnamon, sweet glazing, seeds, and nuts. Then on number 8, we have the next variety of bread, which is baguette. A baguette is a long, thin loaf of French bread that is commonly made from basic lean dough. It is distinguishable by its length and crisp crust. A baguette has a diameter of about 5 or 6 cm and a usual length of about 65 cm, although a baguette can be up to 1 meter long. Then on number 9, we have pita. Pita is a family of yeast leavened round flatbreads baked from wheat flour, common in the Mediterranean, Middle East and neighboring areas. Breads like Arabic bread, Syrian bread, Greek pita, etc. are the members of pita family. Then on number 10, we have bagel. A bagel is a bread product originating in the Jewish communities of Poland. It is traditionally shaped by hand into the form of a ring from yeasted wheat dough, roughly hand-sized, that is first boiled for a short time in water and then baked. Bagels are often topped with seeds baked on the outer crust, with the traditional ones being poppy or sesame seeds. Some may have salt sprinkled on their surface and there are different dough types such as whole grain or rye. Bagels can be eaten toasted or untoasted. Then we have donut on number 11. A donut is a type of fried dough, confection or dessert food. Donuts are usually deep fried from a flour dough and typically either ring shaped or a number of shapes without a hole and often filled but can also be ball shaped. You may be confused between bagel and donut as they both appear to be somewhat similar, but there exists a difference. A bagel is like a bread product, while a donut is a type of fried dough confectionery. The major difference between the two is that while the bagel is baked, the donut is deep fried. Then on the last one, we have bread sticks. Bread sticks, also known as grissini, grissino or dipping sticks, are generally pencil-sized sticks of crisp, dry, baked bread that originated in Italy. So, with this, I conclude the video. Hope you would have learned a few new words and understood the differences. If yes, then continue liking the stuff on my channel, remain connected by subscribing, encourage me by your feedbacks in comment section, and sharing the video as much as you can. Thank you for watching.